Well, welcome to the 700 Club. President Obama is sticking to his guns. He laid out his ideas for new taxes and more government in his State of the Union speech last night.
Well, Republicans, of course, have a very different view, and that's likely to mean more gridlock in Washington this year. John Jessup has the story.
Against a backdrop of a struggling American economy and stubbornly high unemployment, President Obama tried to highlight improvements and at the same time made the case for his re-election.
The state of our union is getting stronger, and we've come too far to turn back now.
He built on the theme of rebuilding the American dream and again spoke of the need for a strong government to ensure economic fairness, pushing hard for more taxes on upper-income Americans.
Do we want to keep these tax cuts for the wealthiest Americans, or do we want to keep our investments in everything else, like education and medical research?
Republicans oppose new taxes and want the free market to sort things out, leaving both sides at odds on how to fix the economy this election year. With troops recently returned from Iraq, the president tried to draw a military analogy of people uniting around a single mission despite different political or social backgrounds. But lawmakers on both sides of the aisle say there's not much evidence of Washington working together in the recent past, and they don't expect it to change anytime soon.
Now this year we've got a couple of other issues that'll make it even more dysfunctional. First is, it's an election year.
The president says it's a do-nothing Congress. Well, it's a do-nothing Senate, and we have a bystander in the White House.
Some of his toughest critics concede the president inherited a bad economic situation, but they say it's his response for which he should be held accountable. In the Republican address, Indiana Governor Mitch Daniels said the president's policies were the wrong answer for the nation's economic problems.
No feature of the Obama presidency has been sadder than its constant efforts to divide us, to curry favor with some Americans by castigating others.
Republicans accuse the president of coming to Capitol Hill to deliver a campaign speech. To make their case, they point out that the president is taking his ideas on the road, starting a three-day tour of five states from Arizona to Iowa so that he can sell his ideas to the American people. John Jessup, CBN News, Capitol Hill.
Well, let the campaigning begin, but it looks like he's ignored the bipartisan panel that he put together. Erskine Bowles and Alan Simpson put out a report, and they said the solution to our deficit, to our current problems, we have to address the entitlement programs. We have to address Medicare. We have to address Social Security. Until we do that, regardless of what taxes you impose, you're not going to solve the budget problem, the deficit problem. That's going to continue to increase and become unsustainable in a very short period of time. So until we really grasp that, just how deep the problem is, and we've got to name it for what it's the entitlement programs, until you get to that point where both sides are saying, we've got to do something here on entitlement programs, we're not going to see solutions anytime soon. Lee Webb has the rest of our top stories from the CBN newsroom. Lee?
Gordon, Newt Gingrich now leads Mitt Romney among registered Republicans nationwide. The latest Gallup poll has Gingrich at 31%, while Romney has 27%. Gingrich is counting on the support of evangelical voters. CBN's David Brody spoke with him about that in an exclusive interview.
I have confessed my weaknesses and that I have had to go to God for forgiveness and for reconciliation. And I think most people can identify, either with themselves or with friends or with loved ones, that life has moments that are very sad that you wish weren't occurring, and that you look back on them and you seek forgiveness for not having been everything you could be.
Gingrich went on to say that he recognizes that there is a war on religion and he's prepared to fight back. You can see that entire interview that David Brody did with Newt Gingrich by going to our website at cbnnews.com. New Jersey Governor Chris Christie says he will veto a same-sex marriage bill that's moving through that state's legislature. He says the public should vote on the issue, but angry state Democrats say they have an obligation to protect civil rights. Christie says hundreds of years of social and religious tradition should not be overturned by 121 members of the New Jersey House. A major solar storm is bringing with it an impressive display of the northern lights. The Aurora Borealis, as it's known, could be seen across northern Scandinavia Tuesday. Weather experts say the lights were part of the strongest solar storm in 6 years. They predict the sun will continue to get more active in the next few years as part of its normal cycle. The radiation, by the way, from solar storms can affect satellite communications and cause cell phone systems to drop calls. Gordon?
Well, it was a beautiful light show. If you weren't up in Canada, I encourage you to go online. There's plenty of video of it. We'll be back with more of the 700 Club right after this.
Relationship with God is not elusive. It's here. He's tangible. We can hear him. He is not some far-off God.
Nearly 2,500 years ago, Buddha sat under a tree and vowed not to move until he attained enlightenment. Well, today, millions of his followers are trying to do the same thing, even though some say it's impossible.
Around the world, 350 million Buddhists are striving for one thing, nirvana.
When one reaches nirvana, it all ends there. The person has been extinguished.
In Buddhism, there is no creator, no supreme God, and no salvation but yourself.
I was taught that you are your own strength. You have to achieve your own glory and achieve spiritual improvement by yourself.
To reach nirvana is to extinguish the self, a nearly impossible task.
In my opinion, reaching nirvana seems a hopeless situation.
And there's no supreme God to help you achieve nirvana. In Buddhism, the fate of your soul depends entirely on you.
Each of us has our own responsibility, and each of us does suffer because of our confusion. But if we come to understand, we can free ourselves from suffering even in this life, much less waiting for someone else to do it for us anytime.
And if you don't get it right in this life, Buddhists believe there's always the next.
Well, we want to show you. We want to hit right at this current thing in our culture today that all religions are equal, that somehow or other all paths lead to the top of the mountain. And we've got to address this, even within the Christian community, that are we unique, and what is unique about the Christian message? Why did Jesus say that he was the way, the truth, and the life, that no one comes to the Father but by me? Jesus said that, and we've got to understand what is in these other religions. Why is it so hard to reach nirvana? Why is it so hard to reach moksha, which is what the Hindus believe? Why do Muslims say they don't have peace with Allah? They don't know that their sins are forgiven. What is it about those religious systems, and what is unique about Christianity? Well, we want you to have it, The Quest for God. Later today, we'll show you how you can get a copy. But first, I want you to meet a couple named Frank and Dawn Matthews. When it came to money, they only had one rule. If you want it, buy it. It's a rule they lived by until the economy fell and their business hit rock bottom.
Frank and Dawn Matthews own a successful sod and seeding company. They specialize in commercial jobs. They bid on contracts and often get them. But the Matthews admit when they first started seeing green, they were foolish about spending the money.
Things that we wanted to do, we just went out and would do it.
We were buying cars, we were taking trips.
Eating out a lot.
Just spending money like it was endless.
But when the economy took a downturn, job contracts were scarce.
We were beginning to get behind, some bills 2 months behind. Some bills 3 months behind. The bills were coming in and stacking up, and the money wasn't. I was paralyzed with fear.
The Matthews used credit cards to get by. Soon they had $35,000 on plastic, in addition to business bills they couldn't pay.
Life started becoming very difficult. I was not sleeping. I was in fear. I was stressed. And I was really struggling with it, just getting out of bed every day, facing the job, facing work. I'm facing my family. I just felt like a failure.
Frank prayed and asked God what was wrong. He says he felt God was telling him his priorities were out of line.
I just knew that the Lord wanted me to repent. And I just said, God, I will live for you. And I felt His Spirit. And God restored my life that day.
Frank prayed for guidance. At the same time, Don started watching the 700 Club.
We always respected Pat and his wisdom, and he would teach about tithing. And I knew that was something that we should be doing and that we were out of God's will.
They not only began tithing to CBN, they also cut up their credit cards.
When we cut them cards, it was a celebration. It just felt so good, a feeling that I had not felt in a long time.
And the Matthews started to see a change.
Work started picking up. Checks were coming in that we didn't expect to come in. The phone was ringing. People were calling me on jobs that we quoted in the past and saying, hey, I've got this job for you. Come out and start immediately. Our life was starting to get exciting again.
Dawn and Frank continued to tithe and decided to give over and above their tithe. 6 months after they increased their giving to CBN, the Matthews landed their largest seating contract ever, nearly $1.5 million.
We were so excited. We jumped up and down. Praise God, we got a chance at life again. And we were being obedient, and God was blessing that, and we just wanted to do more and more and more.
The Matthews began paying off their cards and business loans and were soon debt-free. This year, the Matthews expect to do $3 million in business. That's double the revenue since they started tithing in 2009.
If you're struggling with your life and your finances or you just don't see a way out, I would just encourage you to become obedient to the Lord and start tithing. When we're obedient, He's going to bless us for that.
He will bless you. He wants to. The good news is that God doesn't keep a record of wrongs. That's what it says in the Bible. You can find it in 1 Corinthians. Love keeps no record of wrongs. He wants to forgive. He wants to set you free from the mistakes of your past. And just like Frank, all it takes on your part is to humble yourself and to seek Him, and to seek Him with all your heart. And when you do that, He wants to respond. He wants to respond in love to say, okay, come home, come home. You can be with me, and I'll bless you. I'll take care of you. I'll provide for your needs. If we start thinking we can do it on our own, that somehow or other we can work harder or do more or find some other way, it's God's way, and when you do it God's way, then you'll get the same blessings that Frank and Dawn got. Well, almost 75% of Americans today say they're stressed out. Mike Richens used to be one of them. He was facing unemployment, bankruptcy, and divorce. Then Mike made a call that lowered his stress level for life.
I don't stress out about our finances anymore. I don't stress about anything anymore, really.
But if you had asked Mike Richens of Meeker, Colorado about his stress level a few years ago, you'd have heard a completely different story. He'd lost his job as an oil drilling consultant overseas. This left Mike and his wife, Karma, $160,000 in debt.
Our debt was outrageous, and I went for almost a solid year without working at all.
It was devastating. You never knew where your next dollar was coming from, if you could eat.
Definitely not the kind of lifestyle the Richens had grown accustomed to.
We were spending our money on goodies, you know, all the nice things for me and my wife. vehicles and campers and property, and I had no way to pay it.
And the bills kept coming. Ultimately, the financial stress took a toll on Mike and Karma's marriage.
Got to where I wouldn't speak to my wife. I said, our debt situation, it was killing me, and it was tearing us apart.
I was left so out in the dark. I had nobody to talk to, nobody to visit with. It felt like I was alone in the world.
Mike and Karma considered divorce and bankruptcy, but instead, they chose to do something else.
The really turning point started one night. I was watching the 700 Club, and it was on the, Pat was speaking on the law of reciprocity. And it was during a telethon. God was telling me, hey, you want things to change in your life? And it just kept coming to me, you know, and kept coming to me. Change, change.
Mike made a change. He joined the 700 Club and turned his focus from himself to others in need. But just minutes after making the call,
this little thing hit me just like it was in it right in the back of my head. It said, that ain't enough.
So the Richens doubled their pledge.
And I'm thinking, we don't even have the $20. Where are we going to get money? And he says, let's just do it. And I didn't question God. I felt the Lord tugging at my heart in that situation, and so did he.
Within 3 days, Mike landed a temporary job, and soon Karma found work too. Even though it was challenging to make their $4,000 a month loan payments, the couple increased their 700 Club pledge again.
Well, a lot of people would call it crazy, but one thing that I've learned is faith in God. I think he had me to the point in my life where I had to learn how to be faithful to him instead of the other things, the material things that we have in life.
Both Mike and Karma say the decision to give to CBN has brought some added benefits.
It was just things started to turn around.
There was always somebody that came up, gave us something, you know, a little bit of money, or we'd open the mailbox and there would be a check or something that we'd overpaid.
And to top it off, within 7 months of his first pledge, Mike landed the best job of his life back in the oil and gas industry.
My income increased tenfold right off the bat.
Trusting God and learning to give has refocused the Richens' priorities and turned their finances and the relationship around. In fact, in just 2 years, the Richens paid off every penny of their $160,000 debt.
I'm a big fan of giving. Give. Do it. Just do it. Let God show you, because God will.
Just do it. Let God show you. Here's the promise. It's from Hebrews chapter 11. Without faith, it is impossible to please him, for he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. I call faith an action. When you put your faith into action, that's when you know you've got it. When you step out and say, I know God's there, I know he's a rewarder, I'm going to diligently seek him. I'm not going to do it one time, I'm going to do it continually because I know I can trust him. That's when you get the blessing. Now, if I can get a drum roll, I've got some great news. Some existing CBN partners, just like Mike and Karma, say we love giving and we want to challenge others to give. So we'll match them dollar for dollar up to $75,000 for the next 30 minutes. Now, let's pray. Lord, we just ask for blessing for this. And Lord, you know the heart cry of the world. How many people are trapped in darkness, and you want your light to go forward. You want your gospel to go forward. So we ask for blessing for this. We ask for multiplication, that it would be doubled and tripled. Do it, Lord. Speak to your people. Your people will be willing in the day of your power. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. You heard it. 75,000, 29 minutes. What a challenge means is existing CBN partners like giving, they want to challenge you to give. They want to challenge you to take a great adventure in giving, to prove God with your tithes, with your offerings, with your gifts. And if you want to get on the plus side of giving, all you got to do is call us, 1-800-759-0700. What we're asking you to do is join the 700 Club. How much is that? Well, it's just $20 a month, 65 cents a day. Some of you say you can join at a higher level. You can go for 700 Club Gold, $40 a month. 1,000 Club is $1,000 a year, and that breaks out to $84 a month. At whatever level God is speaking to you to give, call us now and say, yes, I want that turnaround. I want to prove God with my tithes and offerings. I want to diligently seek Him, not on a one-time basis, but I want to create a lifestyle of giving. When you do that, that's when the blessings come. So call us, 1-800-759-0700. Terry?
Well, one of our goals here at CBN, one of our passions, is to share the love and the knowledge of God with all people. But in order to do that effectively, we need to understand what they believe. For millions of Buddhists around the world, the ultimate goal for them is to reach something they call nirvana. But it's a goal that many Buddhists admit is almost impossible to achieve.
The quest for God.
Around the world, 350 million Buddhists are striving for one thing, nirvana.
In my opinion, reaching nirvana seems a hopeless situation.
The hard road, because you realize that ultimately you can't really have nirvana until all beings have nirvana. So then that makes it really tough.
Gordon's put a wonderful teaching together for all of us called The Quest for God. Gordon, one of the things that I find so astonishing about some of these religions that are looked at and talked about in here, even before we get to what is it we believe, is that as hopeless as it may seem, the quest for God in the heart of humanity is so great that we keep, not we, but many faiths
all
keep,
all,
we
all
do keep
it's
reaching
a, it's
for
it's a universal.
It, yes.
Solomon said he's put eternity in our hearts. And with that, we've got to understand there's a longing to be with Him. We were created for relationship with God. That was God's intent. He wanted to come down in the cool of the evening and talk with us. He wanted to have relationship with us. And when we don't have that, we're looking for it. Where's Daddy? What's my purpose in life? What is all this about? So all cultures everywhere throughout time have had a search for God. And we've invented all kinds of difficulties, haven't we? We've put it on works. How can I meditate enough? How can I do enough good things? How can I somehow make myself good enough so that God will pay attention to me? But that's not the gospel. The gospel is, since the beginning of time, since the Garden of Eden, God's been calling out to us, Adam, where are you? And He's been looking, how can I send a Savior to bring my children home to me again so that all their sins can be taken care of? When you look at the other religions, they all say, if you go to a mosque and ask an imam, do you have peace with Allah? Do you know your sins are forgiven? He'll say, no, I don't know. Do you know you're going to paradise? No, I don't know. Even the Prophet Muhammad didn't know. And if he didn't know, how can your average Muslim know? If you go to the monastery and ask the Buddhist monk, Do you know the way to nirvana? Have you achieved that? And he'll say, no, I haven't. If you go to the Ganges River and ask the sadhus who are meditating there, do you have moksha? Have you arrived? And they'll say, no.
But in our faith, we are the only faith where God reaches down to us with, as you said, the desire to have relationship, and we're satisfied. We find that it's not something far away that we're striving for that never occurs. It really is personal. It's all in here, the quest for God, understanding what others believe so that you can also understand what it is we believe and then how to share that faith. That's the mandate that Jesus gave us when He left, was take what I've taught you, take who I am, take it to the world. So you need to have this. The quest for God is available to you. And how do you get a hold of it? Well, you join the 700 Club. We're asking you to be a part of reaching out to the world with the love and the knowledge of Jesus Christ that Gordon was just talking about. And in practical ways as well, we're reaching out to people who are in need. So we want you to be a part of that. It's 65 cents a day, $20 a month to join with all of us. And go to your phone right now. Phone call's free. It's 1-800-759-0700. 65 cents a day, $20 a month. Make you a 700 Club member. But let me show you the club levels that you have an opportunity to join at, because it's important that we hear from you right now with this challenge before us. Maybe you're already a 700 Club member. Why don't you go up to 700 Club Gold? $40 a month, or you can join the 1000 Club. That's $84 a month. We have a 2500 Club level, a Founders level, even something we call Chairman's Circle. And we've heard from lots of people this week who say, I want to be a part of this, giving $10,000 or more a year. When you join, we're going to send you The Quest for God. We really want you to have this teaching. It is awesome. When you join 700 Club Gold, we're going to send you three of these. We keep one for yourself, two for your friends. And if you join the 1000 Club, we're going to send you five. If you've got a big family like mine, you probably want everybody to have one. So call now. We need to hear from you. Gordon.
Yeah, I want you to have this. The Quest for God, when you understand what the other major religions actually believe, and we've allowed them in this DVD to put it in their own terms, to say, this is what we believe. When you understand that, and you understand how difficult it is for them to find any kind of peace with God, then it just encourages you to preach the gospel to the uttermost parts of the earth, for every nation, every tribe, every tongue, to hear the good news that God has taken care of it. Jesus has made the way. And that's what we're about here at CBN. A portion of every gift to the 700 Club goes into the work of CBN International to preach the gospel, not in English, but in the languages of the world. We're in over 40 different languages, over 130 different countries. We're preaching the gospel, and we're doing it in your name when you're a member of the 700 Club. So if you're already a member, thank you. You're a part of everything we're doing. And I would challenge you to consider increasing, to say, okay, let's go more this year. Let's let this year be the year where we increase and go even further, because the people of the world need to hear the good news. Well, Scott and Brandy Spires were $3,500 in debt, and they promised the bank they'd have the money by the end of the day. There was just one problem. Scott and Brandy had no idea where they were going to get the money.
We had a tough time paying our bills.
We had a teeny one-bedroom apartment and this old junky car.
We only had one couch, one piece of furniture right after we got married.
Like many newlyweds, Scott and Brandy Spires started out with very little. Brandy had just graduated from college and was working at a tutoring company. Scott was finishing his degree and working part-time.
It was a very emotional time. Brandy and I really had to seek the Lord about how we were supposed to get out of this financial situation, which is very tough.
Then Brandy learned the tutoring company she worked for was closing because the owners were leaving the state. Scott suggested they buy the business. It seemed impossible. They had no money for a down payment and thousands of dollars of credit card and student loan debt.
I told Brandy, I said, it's going to be okay, because I feel like God has put in my heart that we're supposed to have that business.
So they spoke to the owners, who agreed to sell the tutoring business to the Spires with no down payment. And they agreed the couple would pay them out of the money they brought in the first year. Now the Spires had their own business and a lot of hard work ahead of them.
The first year was financially very rough.
With payroll and other expenses, Scott and Brandy weren't clearing much from the business. But they soon learned a lesson that would turn their finances around.
I remember the first day I learned about tithing, we were sitting down watching 700 Club. I looked at Brandy and I said, I think we need to start giving. We didn't have much to give, so we gave $20.
Even just $20, when you have to borrow money for food sometimes, it seemed silly and unreasonable to give even $20.
If they didn't have money, they gave away their possessions.
There was one time where we needed $3,500 by 5 o'clock.
And God just put on my heart, He said, you gave, you did what you're supposed to do. Everything is gonna be okay.
The day the money was due, the bank called Scott.
And so the bank said, what are you going to do? And I said, I will bring in a check before you close. I said, so do you know someone that's gonna bring you a check? And I said, no. And I said, but I will bring it in before you close. Before 5 o'clock, I will bring in the check. And they said, okay.
A few hours later, a new student's mother walked in and paid for a tutoring package in full.
She comes in and says, I wanna buy 140 lessons up front, where most people buy 8 or 9. It was about 4:30, so we had 30 minutes to get to the bank. We needed $3,500, and she wrote us a $4,000 check.
In just a few years, the Spires tutoring business has grown from 20 students to 70, and from 4 teachers to 10. They bought a house and paid off $40,000 in debt.
Well, we give now, more now than what we made before we got the business. So it's been absolutely amazing about how God has blessed us completely with our personal and business finances.
Scott and Brandy, what an incredible story, and an incredible story of perseverance. Here they are struggling, and God gives them an idea for a new business. And so Scott says, okay, I'll do that. I'll see what I can do. And they acquired a new business. And they also lived a life of giving. And even when they didn't have cash to give, they looked for things that they could give. You know, they started scouring through their house, what are we no longer using that somebody else could use? And they gave, and they gave consistently, and God came through for them. That's the secret. It's when you do it consistently that you see the blessing. If you want to get on the plus side of giving, give us a call, 1-800-759-0700. Just say, yes, I want to join the 700 Club. I want to be a part of preaching the gospel around the world. I want to be a part of Operation Blessing to help people around the world. And if that's you, call us right now, or you can log on to CBN.com. When you give through the internet on a monthly basis, we call it Pledge Express, electronic monthly giving. The bank does all the work. There's no checks to write, nothing to mail in. And you know you'll be consistent in your giving every single month. We save so much on the processing we can send is our gift back to you. Pledge Express for Power for Life, monthly teaching CDs from Pledge Express. So you can either ask for it when you call on the phone, 1-800-759-0700, or you can log on to CBN.com. Well, Russell and Margie McDaniel thought they were ready to retire. Then the recession hit, Russell got sick, and they found themselves more than $50,000 in debt.
We had a lot of bills. We had credit card debt. We had personal loans.
A few years back, Russell and Margie McDaniel were looking forward to retirement, but not in the way that it was thrust upon them.
I was sick at the time, and the bills were just kept coming in. We would pay them. We would have money to pay them, but it was nerve-wracking. I think a lot of people experienced that.
And that led to anxiety and sleepless nights.
There were nights I would wake up and he said, well, we're not gonna be able to make it.
After Russell retired, the couple still had to pay off two new cars, $50,000 in credit card debt, and more in personal lines of credit. Without Russell's income, they were spending $1,800 a month more than they were bringing in.
You worried about losing the house, you worried about losing your car. You just worried about losing everything.
We decided no matter what, come what may, that we were not going to stop tithing. We were going to continue to tithe and give no matter what, even if we went bankrupt.
One place the McDaniels gave was to the 700 Club.
I feel that we're doing what God has called us to do when we give to CBN, when we help the less fortunate, the people being saved. All of that blesses us, blesses our heart to see people coming into the kingdom of God.
At the time Russell retired, Margie was working part-time for a small cosmetics company. That year, the company hired her full-time and gave her a bonus equal to an entire year's salary. The next year, she got another big promotion.
I was promoted to plant manager, and I received an increase twice the salary I had before. So it was God, that was God honoring our giving, honoring our faithfulness, and we knew it was Him.
Russell and Margie continued to increase their ties to their church and to CBN and committed to obey all that God was telling them to do. That's when Margie's company was bought out and she was given early retirement. To reward her service, the company gave Margie a huge exit bonus, enough to pay off their cars, credit cards, even the balance on their house.
God honors His word, but you have to learn to trust Him. You have to learn to be obedient.
You have to learn to trust Him, and you have to learn to be obedient. That's the secret. And when you do it consistently, that's when the blessings come. If you want to get on the plus side of giving, give us a call, 1-800-759-0700. Just say, yes, I want to be like Russell and Margie. I love what CBN is doing. I love to see souls added to the kingdom. If you want to see the gospel preached around the world, if you want to see people in India, Thailand, Indonesia, Middle East, Africa, Latin America come to know the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. If you want that, join the 700 Club. A portion of every gift goes into the work of CBN International. A lot of people don't know this, but 90% of our audience is outside the United States. We're getting huge audiences in India, in Indonesia, in Nigeria. 80% of the population say we've seen a CBN program in the past year. Those numbers are staggering, but that's what our surveys are showing. And you're a part of it when you join the 700 Club. So if you're not a member, now's the time to join. 1-800-759-0700. And if you are a member, consider an increase. We're in the middle of a $75,000 challenge. We need to match it. And if I can get a drum roll, we've got some great news. Some partners are saying $75,000 isn't enough. We've got to double this thing. We've got to take it all the way to $150,000. And we get to the end of the hour. Let's pray. Lord, we ask for blessing for this, and we ask for multiplication, that you would increase. And for those watching and making decisions right now, I just ask that you would speak to them and let your peace overshadow them, that they would know that you have their future. Be with them, Lord, for we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. You heard it, $150,000. We've got to the end of the hour. 21 minutes, 25 seconds. So go to the phone and call us and say, yes, I want to be a part of everything CBN is doing around the world. Let's go over to Wendy.
Thanks, Gordon. Well, there are 7 billion people in the world today. And while their religious beliefs may vary, one thing remains the same. They're all on a quest for God.
In our world today, people say there are many paths to God because all religions are basically the same. Nothing could be further from the truth. Not all paths lead to the top of the mountain. While other religions require you to somehow work your way to heaven, the Christian faith is unique. Instead of us searching for God, we know that Jesus has been searching for us. He has completed the work needed for you to spend eternity with Him.
In The Quest for God, Gordon Robertson shows how you can overcome guilt, hear from God, and understand His plan for your life. Plus, learn what sets Christianity apart from all other religions. This powerful tool can help you share the gospel with those you care about the most.
I want you to enjoy the security that comes from knowing beyond a shadow of a doubt that you have favor with God forever.
The Quest for God, available now.
There aren't many ways to heaven, are there? And it's not politically correct to say it, but I love to say it. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, and no man comes to the Father except by Him. You know, I can tell you from personal experience, anything the world has to offer does not satisfy. The only thing that satisfies is a relationship with Jesus Christ. If you've tried everything and you've come up empty, we have something that can help you. It's Gordon's new teaching. It's called The Quest for God. In here, you're going to learn how to pray, how to communicate with your Heavenly Father, how to understand His unconditional love for you, and so much more. We want you to have The Quest for God. How do you get it? Pretty simple. You just join the 700 Club. Just call 1-800-759-0700 and say, you know what? I can do 65 cents a day. I can do $20 a month. You know, we need your help to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ around the world. Like Gordon said, most of our audience is outside of this country where most people are not believers. So we need to put this in your hands for your own self and for friends and family. If you want to join at the gold level, which is just $40 a month, we're going to send you 3, one for you, 2 for friends. And at the $84 a month, 1,000 Club level, we're going to give you 5 for all those people that you've been praying for. So The Quest for God is our gift to you. We're in the middle of a $150,000 challenge right now. So that means if you go to your phones right now, your pledge will be matched dollar for dollar. So please, we need your help. Call us right now. Gordon?
I want you to have this, The Quest for God. The more you understand about Hinduism, Buddhism, Islam, the more you understand, the more your heart goes out to people who are under those systems. The more you understand the bondage, really, that they're under, how impossible it is for them to have peace, to have security, to know that God is with them, that God loves them, that God wants to have a relationship with them for all eternity. The more you understand how difficult it is for them, the more your heart goes out to them and you understand why Jesus came, why He said, yes, let's take the gospel to the ends of the earth, to the uttermost reaches. Let's do it. And together we can. Now really in the history of the church, how many, you know, the opportunities available to us, what technology has enabled us to do with television, with the internet, with smartphones, we can literally reach this generation in our lifetime. And we need help to do that. We need your support. So if you want to be a part of preaching the gospel around the world, over 130 countries, over 40 languages, the major languages of the world, if you want to be a part of that, call us right now, 1-800-759-0700. Just say, yes, I want to be a part. I want to do my part to preach the gospel. Some of you say you can give more than 700 Club, and we'd encourage that. If you're an existing 700 Club member, think about increasing. Think about going for 700 Club Gold. Think about 1,000 Club. That's $1,000 a year, and that breaks down to $84 a month. 2,500 Club is $2,500 a year, and then Founder, $5,000 a year. At whatever level God is speaking you to give, now's the time to do it. Give us a call, 1-800-759-0700. For many Americans, 2010 was a tough economic year, but for Becca Farmer, it was the best year her small business had ever seen.
Becca Farmer is a single mom and businesswoman who has made a good life for herself and her son. In 1985, she opened a mattress store. By 1994, she was doing so well, she decided to buy a building of her own. But, like many other business owners, Becca was hit hard in 2008 by the recession.
I thought, oh my gosh, you know, what's going to happen here? If it gets worse, I don't know if we'll make it.
Even though she'd paid off nearly 85% of the building mortgage, she couldn't keep up with the bills. Refinancing was out of the question because banks weren't lending money. She needed a miracle.
I didn't want to lose the building after paying it all these years and being that close to paying it off.
A longtime CBN partner, Becca routinely called the 700 Club when she needed prayer and encouragement. This time was no different.
A guy named Rex was on the phone, and when he prayed, he said, you know, God is, he's really going to bless your business. He said, watch and see what he's going to do. I believed it. I really felt it, and I really believed it, that it was going to change.
Becca had always given tithes and offerings to the Lord, even in the midst of financial hardship. But as her income decreased, so had her giving.
2009 came when I prayed with Rex. I thought, you know, I just have to take that leap and believe that it's going to come.
She put her hope in God and trusted Him to help her business succeed.
I went into my store the next day, and at the top of our daily journal where we log all of our sales, I claimed it. I wrote on there, we claim in Jesus' name this will be the best July ever. And it was our best July ever. July, August, September, and October, they were the best we've ever had.
And as her finances turned around, she increased her giving each month.
I just want to give more and more and more and get it back to where we were.
2009 became Becca's best year on record. That is, until 2010, which was even better.
There was no question it was from God. It's not me. I haven't changed anything. It's God. He's bringing the people in. They're buying. And I think through this I've learned that when you pray, you have to believe. This time around I believed God's going to do this. And He did.
When you pray, you have to believe. Becca's echoing the words of Jesus. And it's from Mark chapter 11. When you stand praying, believe that you have already received and you will have it. These aren't my words. These are the words of Jesus Christ. And when you start believing that you already have it, when you put your faith into action to say, okay, I'm going to trust God. I know He's a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. So I'm going to pray and I'm going to start praying specifically for what you need. If you need an increase in income, pray for that. What's the way, Lord? Give me the solution. Give me the idea. Give me the blessing. When you back that up to say, okay, I'm going to obey what you tell me to do. If you tell me to give, I'm going to give. And I'm going to be doing that diligently and regularly. And then you know you've walked into one of the greatest secrets of the universe. We call it the law of reciprocity. Give, and it will be given unto you. If you want to get on the plus side of giving, give us a call, 1-800-759-0700. Just say, yes, I want to be a part of everything you're doing around the world. I want to be a part of Operation Blessing. I want to be a part of CBN International. I want to see the gospel preached around the world. You can do it when you join the 700 Club. Well, as an Army veteran, Tony Rose spent his life serving his country. But when he retired, Tony realized that it would take more than just his military pension to pay the bills.
After Tony Rose retired from the Army, he and his wife Bev moved to Kentucky. He started a successful counseling practice, but even with his military retirement, their finances weren't what they had expected.
I was doing okay as a therapist with the income that was coming in, but I wasn't really realizing what I thought we should be earning at that point in our life.
Tony and Bev are Christians, but tithing was not a big priority.
It was not really a commitment. It was like something that you ought to do.
They started watching the 700 Club and learned the biblical principle of reciprocity, which says, give and it shall be given unto you.
And taking a look at it from a logical point of view, seeing that, you know, if God promised this, it will happen, and how I could invest or what I could do, you know, in faith, trusting God, that He would take that little bit and make it more or make it what we needed.
We prayed and made the decision to give more.
They started tithing, and almost immediately, Tony noticed a change in their finances.
Simultaneously, it seems that the pay doubled when we decided to start tithing.
They give to CBN Monthly through Pledge Express.
CBN seems to just be so widespread in helping so many people.
I can't go to all the world and be a missionary, but CBN can because they're out there. And if I can't go, then I sure can help support those that do go. And that's what CBN does. The Lord has promised that He will take care of our needs. He didn't say, I'll make you a millionaire. He might someday. But He said He would take care of our needs. It would suffice for what we needed every day. And Beverly and I have come to trust that. And when we have needed something, it's been there.
I love what Tony says. I can't be a missionary, but I can help support. I can help send. And he's echoing what the Apostle Paul said. How can they go? How can they hear unless there's a preacher? And how can they preach unless they're sent? And you can be part of sending the gospel around the world. We've trained Christians in their own cultures and how to preach the gospel to their own people. We're doing it in Hindi in India. We're doing it in Bahasa Indonesian in Indonesia. We're doing it in Thai in Thailand. We're doing it in Mandarin. We're doing it in Cantonese. We're doing it in the language of the world, and we're doing it in your name when you're a member of the 700 Club. You're part of everything we're doing around the world. So if you want to preach the gospel to every nation, call us. We want to do that. That's our goal. We want to see the gospel preached around the world. And if that's you, give us a call, 1-800-759-0700, and just say, yes, I want to be a part of it. We're in a $150,000 challenge, and some partners are saying that's not enough to get the job done. They want to take us all the way to $225,000, and we get no more time, so we need to pray. Lord, we just ask for blessing for this. We ask for multiplication. And Lord, we claim again, your people will be willing in the day of your power. Lord, our heart and our desire is to see the knowledge of you cover the earth as the waters cover the sea. We want to see 900 million Hindus come to know the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ, 350 million Buddhists to know you, 1.6 billion Muslims to know you. Enable us to preach your gospel. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. You heard it, $225,000. We've got less than 9 minutes to go, and we need to hear from you. Give us a call, 1-800-759-0700. It's been a great day, but we've got 81,000, and we can get the red number up, 81,000 on a wonderful $225,000 challenge. And we're getting some help with it right now from Wendell, Idaho, a 2,500 Club member doubling to founder. $5,000. And from Superior, Wisconsin, they say we want to be Superior. They're going to Chairman Circle.
$10,000.
That takes us down to $61,000 with 8 minutes and 16 seconds to go. Go to the phone and call us and say, yes, I want to be a part of everything you're doing. When you call, when you join the 700 Club, I want you to have this, the quest for God. You need to hear from, in their own words, what Buddhists say about Buddhism. what Hindus say about Hinduism, what Muslims say about Islam, to say how hard it is to find peace, how hard it is to find nirvana. How can you know that Allah, you have peace with Allah? Well, in those religions, they don't know. They don't have a way. They don't get to the top of the mountain. And Christianity is unique. It's the one where Jesus comes and says, I'll take care of it. I'll pay the penalty. I'll die for you so that you can be with me for all eternity. If you want it, if you want to understand why it's so difficult in these other religions and what is so unique about Christianity and why we need to preach the gospel now more than ever so the nations can know the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. If you want it, give us a call. 1-800-759-0700. Terry?
Well, one of the ways that they know is when they see the love of Christ in us as we reach out to them in their place of need. The couple in our next story scraped every penny. They worked around the clock, but it still wasn't enough to pay for their daughter's surgery. Take a look.
Like most twins, Wen Jing and her brother Wen Ming have a lot in common, but they also have their differences. Wen Ming is the more serious child, while Wen Jing has always been more playful. Another big difference? Wen Ming has been healthy, while his sister has always been sick.
We had to take Wen Jing to the doctor a lot for the flu, sometimes 4 or 5 times a month. She was really skinny.
And as Wen Jing got older, the Dings noticed their daughter's personality changing too.
Before, she could always make her brother laugh. But all of a sudden, she didn't want to play anymore. She barely talked and hardly ever smiled.
Finally, doctors diagnosed Wen Jing with a serious heart condition and said if she didn't have surgery soon, she would die. Mr. and Mrs. Deng both work 12-hour days at a brick factory. Their combined income is just $350 a month. Not enough for surgery to save Wen Jing's life.
I called one organization for help, but they refused to do anything because they said they didn't want to waste their money on Wen Jing. They said her heart problem was too severe.
Then the Dengs heard about CBN.
The people at CBN were so nice. They seemed to really care about our daughter.
First, we arranged for a doctor and hospital to provide open-heart surgery. A surgeon repaired the damaged valve in Wen Jing's heart, and within months, she was the picture of health.
We really thank CBN for helping us when no one else would. We will never forget you.
My husband and I are so grateful. But you know who is really excited about this? Her brother.
I love my sister, and I'm so glad that she's healthy now.
I can run and jump, and I am very happy. The surgery healed my heart.
Can you imagine being a parent and not being able to help your child, knowing it could be done? But no matter how many hours you work, no matter how much you do, you can never, ever save enough money to make it happen. Then, CBN members, you heard about that need, stepped right into the middle of it, and provided what their child needed free of charge, just out of the love of God. How else can we possibly share the gospel more meaningfully than to reach right into the center of people's need and to say, God loves you, and he sent me to tell you so. You're helping us do that around the world. That's why we're asking you to call right now. We really need to hear from you. Join the 700 Club at whatever level God speaks to you. Do something today to make a difference. And by the way, when you join, will you use something we call Pledge Express? It's electronic monthly giving. It means your bank does all the work. You don't have any of the hassle, and you don't have to remember stamps or envelopes or even just the mailing of it. It saves us processing dollars, and so we're able to send you Power for Life teachings every month. We think this will be a blessing to you, even as you reach out and bless the nations of the world. So thank you in advance. Call now, 1-800-759-0700. Gordon?
Well, Deanie Martinez is a big believer in Superbook. Her 4 sons grew up watching the original series, and now her children are big fans of the new Superbook.
Deanie Martinez loves spending time with her grandkids when they come over, and there is never a shortage of fun things to do. When it's time to come inside, a favorite activity is watching Superbook. CBN's characters come alive in new state-of-the-art 3D animation.
I like watching Bible stories because I get to learn about the Bible.
Deanie is no stranger to CBN Superbook. She played the original series for her four boys when they were growing up in the 1980s.
I'd just turn on the Superbook and they would automatically all sit around on the sofas and watch it, and they really enjoyed it.
And CBN has taken the 21st century Superbook edition to a whole new level for today's media-savvy kids. A Superbook link right on CBN.com's homepage.
Kids love to play games, and this way it keeps their mind on what the Word of God says, and they can picture how it really was in that day.
So between the new Superbook website and the all-new animation series, Deanie knows her grandkids are seeing the Bible come to life.
Thank you, CBN, for Superbook.
We want to bring the Bible to the children of the world. Our goal over the next 5 years, 300 million children throughout the world to see this new version of Superbook, and you can be a part of that when you join the 700 Club. Here's the languages that we're looking at. We've got 20 languages just in the initial translation series. Just imagine, you can be a part of preaching the gospel in Vietnamese, in Portuguese, in Ukrainian, Japanese, Cantonese, Mandarin, Tagalog, Nepal, the language of Nepal, Bengali, Urdu, Telugu, Tamil, the languages of India. You can be a part of all of it when you join the 700 Club. If you're not a member, join with us and say, yes, I want to bring the Bible to the children of the world. Call us right now. Let's go over to Christy at the phones. Christy?
Well, Gordon, throughout this show, we've been talking about Buddhism. In fact, there are 350 million followers. It's not just a religion, it's a way of life.
People who really want to achieve nirvana need to remove themselves from society and leave everything in order to keep their minds and soul peaceful.
When one reaches nirvana, it all ends there. The person has been extinguished. In my opinion, reaching nirvana seems a hopeless situation.
Gordon?
All right, it's been a great day. We've had a $225,000 challenge. Columbus, Indiana, not Ohio, Indiana, $6,000 founder.
Awesome.
We had a $225,000 challenge, and we're counting down to victory with all the time gone on it.
Woo, there we
you
go.
Gave $230,592. We leave you these words from Jesus from John 14. If you love me, keep my commandments. For all of us, God bless you. We'll see you again.
Seeking to become God, and part of becoming God is to transcend good and evil.
Ultimately, you can't really have nirvana until all beings have nirvana. So then that makes it really tough.
Your standing with God is based upon what you do.
He is a master. I am just a servant. I must fear him.
Our relationship with God is not elusive. It's here. He's tangible. We can hear him. He is not some far-off God.
Jihad is the ultimate price you can pay. Jihad is martyrdom. It's dying for the cause.